Hey everybody, welcome back to the MacWhisperer Academy. I'm Dylan Stewart. They call me the MacWhisperer. And if you're one of those people that always has a ton of open tabs on your browsers, and you freak out when you think about quitting your browser or restarting your computer because then you might lose all of those open tabs, then this lesson is just for you. Let's hop on in and get started. With browsers, everyone's got their favorite. Maybe you use Chrome all the time, or you just love the way Firefox looks. But for me, I use Safari almost all the time, and I recommend other people do the same. You see, Safari has this great functionality right out of the box. It automatically syncs with all of your Apple devices. You can easily organize your bookmarks and use bookmark folders. Even your passwords get saved and automatically synchronized across all of your devices. It's just a super simple, very Apple-like app, and I love it. Safari recently got a major upgrade to version 15, and there were several tweaks and a lot of new functions that got added, but one feature, tab groups, it's a complete game changer. In this video, I'm gonna show you how to use tab groups to completely transform how you browse the internet. And along the way, I'm gonna drop some other amazing tips about how I use tabs in Safari. Let's start by hopping over to the computer. And I'll open Safari up from my dock. Tabs are awesome. They've already changed how most of us use our browsers. With tabs, we no longer need to keep dozens of separate windows open when we're browsing the internet. You can keep one window open, but with multiple web pages inside of it, like what you see on the screen here. As helpful as this is, it can sometimes cause issues. People will open tons of unrelated websites into a single window, like this. There's things that just don't belong together. There's Amazon pages and Apple support pages and websites about markups. You can waste a ton of time flipping through all of these open tabs and you get lost, constantly forgetting what window is where. So what began as something that was helpful becomes a cluttered, disorganized mess. I propose a more organized way to use tabs. It starts with using separate windows for separate purposes. For example, let's open a fresh window here. And in this window, I'm only going to open web pages that relate directly to paying my bills. It's easy to do because I've got a bookmark folder right here, and I can click on that and open all of those bills into tabs on one page. That makes it really easy for me to stay focused. And then when I'm done paying a specific bill, I can just close the tab. And when I'm done paying my bills altogether, I can just close my window like this rather than closing each of the separate tabs. By keeping your tabs organized within separate windows, you streamline your browsing and you find you leave fewer tabs open and it becomes easier to locate the tabs you need. Now let's open an empty window by coming to the File menu here and clicking on New Window. One of the best places to use tabs is within a web search. So let's do a simple search for iPad tips. One of the bad habits I see in most people's web browsing starts with how they search. They do a Google search like this, but then they click on the first link they see, like this, and they immediately leave their search behind. Now, usually you can get back to it just by clicking the back button, right? But what happens when you get a little further into that website and you're clicking here and you're clicking here and you're clicking on additional pages and you're going to other parts over here and all of a sudden you lose the plot? It's several steps to get back to your original search. And so what most people do is they just close their window, open a new window, and start the search all over again. This is super ineffective. Instead, what I want you to start doing is that when you do a web search, I want you to right-click on the links you'd like to see and choose Open Link in New Tab from here. I want you to notice that when I click on that, we see new tabs open up on the tab bar. Let's do it again. Did you see it happen? Right there in the upper right? Let's do another one. Now, what's nice about this is without losing track of what I'm doing, I can open as many links as I want. I can just keep clicking them, and I never have to go back to the search because I never left it. Once I've got enough windows open, I can look through the sites by clicking on them like this. Or I can hover over it and I'll see a small preview of what that page has to offer. If I find a site that I just don't like, all I have to do is click the little X and it will close that one tab instead of closing all the tabs or closing the entire window or starting back over again. You can even change the order or position of the tabs by grabbing any tab and dragging it to the left or over to the right. If you keep your windows organized, things are simple. But sometimes you open a tab in your window that doesn't really belong there. No problem. It's easy to deal with. You can simply grab any tab and detach it from the window by clicking on it and pulling it down like this. This allows that tab to be a new window that you can then add additional tabs to if you need to. So you can right-click on anything else here and begin to just add to this particular window. You can also take a tab from an existing window and put it onto a different window. It's really easy to do. All we're going to do here is detach this one and drag it right into the window over here, and immediately that tab rejoins these other tabs on this window. And sometimes you just end up with too many windows with too many open tabs all over the place, and you just need to bring them all together into one single window. That's pretty easy to do by going up to the window menu here and choosing merge all windows right here. That puts all those tabs together into one window so you don't have to keep switching around. And another cool way that you can use tabs with Safari is through bookmark folders. You see, if you have your bookmarks organized into folders, you can easily open all those bookmarks into tabs simply by clicking on it like this and going down to where it says open in tabs. And it opens all of those web pages automatically. This is something I do all the time. It makes it super easy for me to get caught up on all my Mac news or take care of my bills or handle a bunch of client projects that are all organized into one of those bookmark folders. Now it's time for a shameless plug. If you want to know more about Safari bookmarks and folders, check out my video all about Safari bookmarks by clicking the link above. You see, Safari's just chock full of little things you didn't know it could do. Here's one of my favorite tricks. If you have a website that you visit all the time, like Google Drive or Facebook or Canva or Amazon, rather than constantly opening that page up, clicking on it, clicking here, or coming into the search bar and typing it up here, you can do this cool thing called pinning a tab. While a tab is open, simply right-click on it and select pin tab, and it will slide that tab over to the left side, replaced by just a fave icon for that page. This allows you to jump right back to that page anytime you want. And what's amazing about it is that even if you close that window and open a brand new window, it's still right there, ready for you to jump right into it. So if you're on Amazon all the time, you can simply right click and pin that, or maybe you want to get your Canva page easily opened. It's great for any website that you use all the time, especially those websites where you always want to start right from the home page. So you can pin that tab there, close the window, or even quit Safari altogether, and you won't lose that page because it's saved there as a pinned tab. All of these tips so far have been amazing. But there's one feature, one brand new way to use tabs that I consider a complete game changer. Before I tell you all about it, take a moment and hit that subscribe button and hit that notify bell so that you'll always know whenever I release new videos. Now, let's talk about tab groups. You know, when I first heard about tab groups when Apple released it, I completely underestimated and misunderstood it. I thought it was very similar to pin tabs or bookmarks, just a different way to clump together the tabs that you use regularly. As it turns out, tab groups are a way to easily keep track of several projects that you're currently working on without having to leave several windows, pages, and tabs open, which is super helpful because sometimes you've got to quit your browser. Sometimes you've got to restart your computer and you don't want to lose everything you're working on. We're going to start by opening up the sidebar on the left side here so that we can begin to look at the tab groups I've created. Now, when I do research for a particular project, I have a tendency to open up several pages and several tabs and flip back and forth between them while I write the script or prepare for the class. This can take me several days or sometimes even weeks, during which time I also have other projects that I'm working on, like getting ready for date night, or my upcoming wedding, or keeping track of ideas for my son's school. And it used to be that I would just bookmark all of those pages, or leave them open in different windows and tabs, which would prevent me from quitting and closing Safari. Sometimes I would even save those bookmarks into notes, or add them into my reminders app. But with tab groups, I can create a group for any project I'm working on. You can see here's a project I've been working on all about HomePods. Or here are some of the date night ideas that I've put together. It's really easy to create a tab group, and there's a couple of ways that you can do it. First, you want to make sure your sidebar is open. Then, up above the sidebar here, there's this button with the plus. Clicking that will allow you to create a new empty tab group, or a tab group with whatever pages are currently open in that window. In this case, I'm going to create a new empty tab group, and I'm going to call this tab group Mac News. This is where I'm going to put any articles or stories that I find while I'm searching the internet that I think are important for me to follow up on. Now I'm going to click back up to the top where it shows the 8 tabs that are currently open. And I can take any one of these existing tabs and right click on it and send it into that tab group I just created. But it's more effective to do it with a bunch of tabs all at once. So let's go back to that page with all those iPad tips. I've got an iPad class coming up shortly and I'm going to use all of these tips, so we might as well put them together and save them somewhere where I can find them later. I'm going to click the plus button up above the tab section, and I'm going to choose new tab group with 8 tabs. And it's going to take all 8 of those and put them together over here where I can call them iPad tips, and they're there ready for me at any given point. And then once you've got a tab group set up, anytime you find another page that belongs there, all you have to do is right click on it and send it right over there easily. Then you can close that window and at any point come back and go right back to where you were. That tab group stays exactly where it was even if I quit Safari. What? You mean I can quit without losing what I was doing? Hold on, let's try that. I don't buy that. I'm gonna quit it. Now it's gone and all those pages are gone with it. Damn. But I come back into Safari and I come right back into my iPad tips page and everything's right there, right where I left them. You can move any of your tab groups around on this list, or you can rename them by simply clicking on them and choosing rename. Or if you're done with that project, you can right click on it and just delete it. But best of all, if you've got a list of tabs that you've collected and you want to save them somewhere in one list or share them with someone, it's super easy to do. All you do is come and click on the tab group, right click on it and choose copy links. Now I can open up a fresh note and paste those links right there, or I can open up an email right here and go ahead and paste them and send them off to anyone that I want. Now it's important to note that tab groups, pin tabs, and bookmarks all serve different purposes. They're all different tools. You see, bookmarks are great for websites that you go to frequently. Sometimes pages that are a little complicated to find, like some of these courses that I've recently purchased, or maybe a quick link into my Zoom recordings or meeting pages so I don't have to hunt around. That's what bookmarks and bookmark folders are great for. Pin tabs are great for sites that you go to all the time where you want to start from the same place, like this Google Drive page, or this Amazon page, or my Canva page. And tab groups are for web pages that you're currently working on, projects that you're in the middle of, ways that you want to keep things organized together in one place, and eventually you might complete that project and just delete them. Unlike pin tabs, any website in a tab group that you change, like this one here, will save the state that you left them in. So if I leave this tab group, and open up a fresh window and go back to that tab group, that page is right where it was. This is different from the way pin tabs work because pin tabs always start you back at the beginning, but tab groups leave you wherever you left them. It's important to keep an eye on this left sidebar as you first start using tab groups. Be aware, are you currently in a tab group or are you on your main window page? You can tell the difference because you can't have pinned tabs within a tab group. So if you don't see your Amazon and Google and Canva pinned tabs, you're probably inside of a tab group, and whatever you do here is gonna get saved and is gonna change that tab group. So you wanna be a little careful working with tab groups so you don't accidentally take it away from a page that you needed because you started a new search or clicked some button. Pay attention and make sure that when you don't need to be on a tab group, you're on the main tab up here. That's what I've got for this lesson about how to use tabs and tab browsing and tab groups in Safari to make you more productive and more organized than ever before. I'm the Mac Whisperer, and it's my purpose and passion to help people get more things done in less time and with less effort on their Apple products than they ever thought possible. If you got great value out of this video, give it a thumbs up so that other people can easily find it. And if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, take a moment and handle that right now. I'm Dylan Stewart. They call me the Mac Whisperer, and I will see you next time.